Legislature can take away, be it however great, by a politician, by monarch, or by emperor. But by the time we reach Garibaldi, isn't it true that in England the piano was becoming really great? The kind of instrument which would cause World War One? No. We can go back to the Boer War. I can go back beyond that. So let's take the Il National, the national anthem of Russia. I have a song at this piece, very interestingly, on the shores near Lake Massachusetts, Italy, that sees my great emperor, the king of Italy, gaining popularity by making, in the end, friends with the relation of Napoleon Bonaparte, that is, Napoleon III, Emperor of France. But apart from the great Paris exhibition of that apart from the great exhibition London 1851, Hyde Park and Crystal Palace, the Paris exhibitions which in part and small opened 1850 to 51. But especially 1867, French Exposition Universelle. And after that, the great Paris 1878. This was the year that the king called himself the king of Italy. There is little doubt that Garibaldi, the general who became a teacher in, was it Uruguay or Haringey, that had this man pronounced the fate of the greatness which would descend and ascend lines of names like Emperor Mussolini. But Garibaldi was, albeit a general, had become a schoolmaster. My friend, if you have thought of getting advice on any piano and you had wanted to play the five notes and imagine the sixth, had you wanted to be Il Generale, you could do no better, you might think, than to go and ask a schoolmaster to lead your armies against the Austrians and the French. But this young lady is here to teach you not the wisdom of how to choose a fine piano, but to choose how to know the difference between an emperor and a real prat. Oh, I never thought that I would have heard this, but since I have sung the national anthem of Greece, that sort of music that in the end, two emperors, Hitler and Mussolini, they all fought finally for this national anthem, which is they're too great to go into. You listen to the Italian national anthem, and you will hear the might of emperors who musically, they started out with the invention of il pianoforte, but totally in the end, lost note sixth of the scale. So plain to see here, have a listen, which version is the one where note six is imagined, and the version one or two, where note six actually takes place. This, my friend, is not the difference between the schoolmaster and the general. It may be the difference between a king and a queen. How can we tell the difference? Well, why don't you sit there, and I will sit here. Bigorexia, that is something that Tyrannosaurus Rex would not have in his vocabulary of fine instruments in the cupboard of the music teacher. But in this nest lock full of extravaganza from the journeys of the great Marshal Bazaine of France and his exit from Mexico by some means which was not chosen by him but chosen more by his friendlier enemies, or those that really hated him probably just sent him off to war to fight on their behalf. But if you choose the right piano, you can be the warrior rather who wins than the warrior who lost his head at the inopportune time, but gained in the American Civil War something far beyond independence. It gained the emancipation of note six. that slaves never, never, never will be slaves. So, in the next elected general that you vote for, Theodore Steinway, or you vote for Heinrich Steinitz, you will hear note six in some, and in others, frankly, I was not ready for that. Monsieur, a jury au piano, la nationale, l'anthème, de la grande Bretagne, et la Russe. Ici, the anthem, la Russe, where might really matter, the note six in the Dolorosa of Tito, tedium, or it never was per the lady, was it, that calls the singer every Thursday morning to need an accompanist to drown her sorrows when the washing machine salesman ringing the doorbell could quite comfortably polish it off on her own in 5 minutes? The Dolorosa. Is it example one that has the truth embodying the truth that note six forgets? Or is it example two? You choose your own piano. This general, neither an emperor nor a monarchy, but gains all from the notes in good harmony. Adios, signori, hey, signorite, when they reach the inevitable. Only believe in one of these. Is it the first?